So we're back onto cycle lanes at Yael Breuer, and we're going to be speaking about particularly Old Shoreham Road. We've both experienced it numerous times. What was your recent experience? Because we've hearing different stories from the cycle lobby, from people against the cycle lanes, and it seems to be most of it, not all, focused on Old Shoreham Road, the criticism or the support.
I know. So the Old Shoreham Road, you know, I've been using the Old Shoreham Road as a car driver. I have also started cycling recently, so I can sort of see things from both points of view. But the Old Shoreham Road, yesterday I was driving there and heavy traffic, both lanes, and then a police car wanted to go through as an emergency procedure, lights flashing, the siren. Couldn't do anything because of the cycle lane that really does take a hell of a lot of space off the road.
Yeah.
You know, all cars tried to move as much as possible, but there was a significant delay. And I, you know, so I could really experience it firsthand. And you really don't see many cyclists on the Old Shoreham Road. So, you know, we've said it before, I have a feeling that that cycle lane may be more problem than advantage in, you know, the global picture.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, emergency vehicles are going along Hove, by Hove Lawns and along by a seafront as well, in front of the Odeon Cinema. That's been an issue as well. I was with a cameraman. We recorded ambulances going along space, and actually they were waiting 2 minutes, till 3 minutes to actually get through the traffic, which is a long time when you wait for an ambulance.
It can be crucial, yes. Absolutely.
So that's not ideal, is it? So what do you think the long-term future is of cycle lanes? Because we do need more cycle lanes. I was speaking to the Conservative councillor Lee Wares about this recently. I've spoken to a lot of the Green Party councillors about it, and there is a need for more cycle lanes, but it's a matter of where they're put in the city, isn't it, I guess? And that kind of the way they're kind of implemented alongside road users.
It's a complicated issue, and, you know, experts really need to be looking at it properly, because when I cycle in town, and when there isn't a cycle lane to cycle in, it's quite scary, I have to say. The traffic, cars get very close to you. It's not something I've been feeling very comfortable doing. On the other hand, you know, the issue of emergency cars is a very important one. You know, everything will, I suppose, need to end up as a compromise in the end. But I definitely get the impression that a decision of let's go for cycle lanes or let's make the centre of Brighton car free, or, you know, is not that simple. It all sounds nice, but
balance.
It needs to be balanced.
Yeah. Okay. We'll leave it there. Yael, thanks for coming in today. Thanks.